Hello and welcome to InVision News. You are watching English Bulletin with me, Ratnakar. The news in detail. Under the jurisdiction of Koradi police station, a young man was seriously injured in a ghastly road mishap on Saturday morning and died shortly thereafter. The identity of the deceased youth is Sushil Siddharth Patel, a resident of Lonara Basti. On Saturday morning, around 11 a.m., Sushil had gone out of his home for some important work on his two-wheeler. Initially riding steadily, Sushil later on increasing his speed and was approaching Bokhara T Point. Near the T Point, somehow due to high speed, he was no longer able to control his vehicle and was moving dangerously. Ultimately, collided forcefully with the signboard. In the impact, Sushil suffered severe head injuries. A crowd gathered at the site and Sushil was immediately taken to a nearby hospital, here where he was declared brought dead. Cops have registered a case of accidental death. The committee appointed by the High Court to submit report regarding challenges in extending treatment COVID-19 patients in private hospitals conducted a hearing on Saturday. During the hearing, which was attended by representatives of 34 out of 59 private hospitals, the private hospitals stated that the rates prescribed for treatment under Mahatma Phule Jan Arogya Yojana were not affordable. As per NMC, the representative of private hospitals pointed out issues concerning treatment under MPJY. The government had taken a stand that COVID-19 patients having 20 alignment covered the treatment under MPJY should be treated at private hospitals. However, many hospitals associated submitted their views. They pointed out that recently prices of medicine and oxygen have increased tremendously. Therefore, the rates prescribed for treatment under MPJY were unaffordable. Unidentified thieves broke open a Bank of India ATM at Mansa situated along the National Highway in the wee hours of Saturday and fled with ₹19,90,500 cash. The thieves cut open the ATM with the help of a gas cutter and stole the cash. The thieves spread black liquid on the CCTV camera and cut open the machine to steal the cash, said Ramtek police. In the morning, the neighboring shopkeeper saw the broken machine and informed the branch manager of the bank. Jitendra Asharam Basakhitre, branch manager of the bank, who is a resident of New Sevdar Layout, Nagpur, informed Ramtek Nagpur police station about the incident over telephone. Cops have registered a case under the relevant section of the IPC. Forensic team and dog squad were also called in, but even they could not find any clues there. Home Minister Anil Deshmukh on Saturday said that CBI should soon make public its inquiry report into Sushant Singh Rajput's death so that people know whether it was a case of suicide or murder. Talking to reporters, he said the Maharashtra government was waiting for the CBI probe report in the case. Replying to a question about reports which said that Rajput's death was a case of suicide and not murder, Deshmukh said, "We have not received any information regarding that. It won't be appropriate to comment on it until we get official information. We will give a statement as and when we received any official information about it," he said. "We want that the CBI inquiry report into the case should soon come before public so that they get to know whether it was a suicide or murder," he added. Nana Patole, Speaker of Legislative Assembly, has asked the top officials to prepare an action plan of ₹1,000 crore for strengthening of healthcare infrastructure in Nagpur district. Already he has sought ₹500 crore for the purpose from Dr. Harshvardhan, Union Health Minister. Now he has asked the offers to add a more component and seek the fund from the center. Patole issued the direction in a meeting held on Saturday. He assured to follow up the action plan with the central government. The plan should be aimed at augmenting the capacity of Indira Gandhi Government Medical College and Hospital, GMCH, AIMS. These hospitals receive patients from all over Vidarbha region. In the meeting, the Speaker of Legislative Assembly took stock of COVID-19 death rate in Nagpur district. MLA Vikas Thackeray, CPM Mitesh Kumar and others were present in the meeting. As many as 22 persons succumbed to COVID-19 on Saturday. With this, the cumulative death toll in the district has reached 2,596. On the other hand, as many as 1,821 persons went home after recovery and obtaining permission from concerned medical authorities. With this, the total number of recovered patients in the district is now 66,998, including patients who have recovered during home isolation and treatment. The recovery rate of the district is now at 82.87%. The total corona positive cases tally of Nagpur district is now at 80,844, with 876 positive cases coming to light in the last 24 hours. While giving a breakup of the deaths, medical official revealed that of the total casualties, 453 and 1,893 victims are from the rural and urban areas of the district respectively, while as many as 250 persons are from outside Nagpur district. Well, that's all from this bulletin. For more updates in and around the city, stay tuned with NBCN News. Till then, Ratnakar says goodbye. Please take very good care of yourself and your family.